And let me first of all introduce to you in the blue corner, fighting out of the ULT fight team in Ayr, Scotland. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Chris Shaw.
Ready or not, here I come. You get high. One bungee and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You get high. Gonna find you and make you one.
Now that I've escaped, sneak you up for me.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, in the blue corner, Chris Shaw. And facing Chris this evening, his opponent in the red corner, fighting out of the Yokau Training Center at the world-famous Bad Company Gym in Leeds, England. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Joe Craven!
So Joe Craven's music actually was especially made for him by Ragnar Vallon, and this is called Off Their Head. Ragnar Vallon does loads and loads of fighters' walk-up music, so fair play to him. One of my favourites is Cap.
Oh, yeah.
Did catchy. I sound like catchy. Proper, like, beatbox? Yeah, this is tunes called Off Their Heads, and that's by Ragnar Vallon, so very nice. When it's over, you ain't leaving alive. Your head's coming clean,
arms are how you even survive. See, I'm Dr. Evil scheming with a gleam in his eye. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, in the red corner, Joe Craven.
So here you go then. 28 fights for Craven, 25 wins, 3 losses. 39 fights for Chris Shaw, 34 wins with 4 losses. This is going to be a very, very hard fight to pick. The number one spot, ladies and gentlemen, here on Yokau 38.
This next contest, ladies and gentlemen, matched at 72.5 kilograms. Scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. And firstly, introducing in the blue corner, fighting out of the ULT fight team in Ayr, Scotland, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Shaw! And standing across the ring in the red corner, his opponent. He fights out of the Yokau Training Center at the world-famous Bad Company Gym in Leeds, England. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Joe. You
know what, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to lie. Chris Shaw doesn't fight often. When he does, he blows people's chins into space. Joe Craven's been over in Thailand training at the Yokau Training Center. Chris has been training with the very experienced Stevie Meikle. This, and you know what, honestly, I have not got a clue who's going to win this. Craven has to be his very, very best. He had a great fight last time out against Jake Purdy. It didn't set the world on fire. He took himself seriously. He's trained over in Thailand. He's been following nutritional advice from a young lady whose name escapes me. I will remember later. And he's been training with my coach, Dan Mitten, in the UK Precision Movement. So he's been doing all what he should be. But when that bell rings, let's see. Chin is a little high of shoulder.
I've been really looking forward to this fight.
Yeah. And the nutritionist, sorry, is Carrie Eckersley, who's been helping Joe. great shape though, Craven.
He's in the best shape I've seen him. I've seen him look, to be fair.
Nice left kick, strong with that short, always has been.
Physically, Shaw's very big.
Chin's too high though, Gavin.
But yeah, he's open to certain shots.
Heavy kick that was from Shaw.
Craven walked right into that as well.
What may be the undoing of Shaw, Gavin, is he cuts a lot of weight, like ridiculous amounts of weight.
Yeah, he looks it.
And that may tell later. Well, left kick is sharp for Shaw.
That could be telling because we know Craven's been and done a really, really effective camp over in Thailand. He's come in shape and stuff like that. And in the past, he's not really. Maybe not taking it as seriously as he wanted to, but that could tell on the stretch
though,
of his fight.
He's
huge. He's absolutely huge. You know, these first couple of rounds, Craven's got to be sharp and smart and clever, and maybe not get too involved in any sort of firefight.
Dangerous from Shaw.
You know, Shaw has expended a lot of energy already, and you could see that. He was starting to blow the end of that round.
Yeah, you know what? His mouth's wide open, isn't it?
This is going to be a tough pace for him to keep this up. I think Craven's better equipped for that sort of fight. You know, Shaw's not. You can see there at the end of that round, he was really.
If you look at the back of Shaw, look how he's breathing. You can see.
He's not comfortable at all.
No, he's not. And he needs. Take his time.
Cornell, 10 seconds. Seconds out.
Let's see, round number two.
Round two.
Number one spot being contested here. 72.5 kilos, Joe being the number one. Throws that left hook.
He's missing a lot as well. It's going to take a lot out of him missing those shots.
Good fight this already, and I knew it would be.
It's intriguing.
Any kid Craven as well, he's only 20. Big score. heavy in that left kick of Shaw's, isn't it?
I think they both settled into this pace a little bit better now as well. Yeah. Picking the shots a little bit more conservative now going forward.
Good left hook, took that well.
Yeah.
Good shot. I'm really scoring in these. Referee breaks that. It's good work from Sewell as well. He knows what's going on.
Quite evenly matched in the clinch there.
Nice. So I know he needs to show better balance with that left kick. Sure.
Second time he's been caught with that, he's been careful. Never in a dull fight, Craven.
No. No, he's never in a dull fight. He's getting caught and makes things hard for himself, and he's dragging a little bit here, guys.
That last shot hurt him a little bit.
Yeah,
then.
It did.
See. Shaw is heavy-handed, very strong.
Yeah.
You've got to give him respect.
You know what? It's a good fight, this, you know.
Yeah.
Already. Time. Good fight this. Very, very intriguing. So we'll see.
Tell now.
The wise words from Gavin Sterritt, two corners, a very experienced one, sweaty-handed commentator.
Corner,
enjoy this. Just join us here on Yokel 38. We're going into round number three.
Seconds.
The British 72.5 kilo. Number one spot.
Sometimes these types of fights,
you know what?
You actually forget your commentator.
I
don't
know.
You?
It's just one of them fights where you end up watching.
Yeah.
Very nice. Gut went down with him, so negates that.
Good.
Good hopping knee. Good show of strength there by Shaw.
Extremely
big score
strong.
To the back here. Yeah. Not getting it right in the target area, but kind of turning the clinch. Shaw, smart work going in from both boxers. It's a real hard fight, this, Gav, and there's going to be some sore bodies tomorrow.
That's
it, really
that
is.
That is for sure. That is without doubt.
Shaw's hands are coming lower and lower. Maybe it's the way he fights. Scored well there, Craven.
I think Craven's got to kick more, really, really trying up this level now and change the gear, because he's got to test, Shaw's gas tank here, because like you say, he will have cut a lot of weight to get to the weight, to the championship weight, but you know, Craven needs to test that now, put to the test his fitness.
It's a good elbow there from Shaw, but he had to take a right hand. Looks like he's falling a little bit apart here, Shaw, defensively, as the younger man started to trying to stamp his authority, but back comes Shaw with his own.
Yeah, he's a bit more laboured in his movements now, a bit more heavy leg. Craven's still got to be careful though, he can't rush in like that. Still got to show Shaw respect.
Nine seconds of this third round, that's been a big one for Craven. He lifts his arms up when he knows, fair play. So if you're enjoying this as much as I am, ladies and gentlemen, and Gavin is and everybody else is at the Macron Centre, listen, we've got a show coming up very, very soon as well on July the 27th. I'm told. Now check out. I might be lying. And all the guys.
Corner in 10 seconds.
Shaw's corner is Stevie Meikle. He needs to be defensively better, Shaw, in the
second. Seconds out.
Big round.
Round four.
That was good. Nice. Looks a lot more measured this round.
Yeah, it is, and he looks like he's...
He's really got the measure now, for sure. Pace and timing and distance, looking good.
Caught there, you know.
He's still got to, this thing, you've still got to watch him. He's dangerous every second.
He's too much on his left kick, Shaw, and then he just gets it caught and bustled to the floor, really. But Craven is doing well here.
For sure, pretty much everything he throws is maximum. There's no
power,
there's no in between, there's
no feeling out later.
Nothing.
You know what that is, Gav? Lack of ring time.
Yeah, everything is power and it's got to land. If it doesn't land, it misses, he's off balance, he loses energy. But you know, when you're fighting someone like that as well, you've got to give them respect for every second of the round, because if they do catch you, it's going to cause a problem.
Yeah, true. Straight right to the body. for Craven. Shaw's dangerous, but he's absolutely spent, I think, Gavin.
He's feeling the pace of this fight now.
Craven's getting this now. My mouth wide open. Shaw cuts much too much weight, Gavin. We're talking like 17 kilos.
Yeah,
it's a hell of a lot, man.
Too much, too much. You know, it's literally a fight before the fight to make that work.
Yeah,
it's not,
I don't know why.
Helping.
I don't know. He's still fighting there, and he's still in brilliant shape. So I'm not criticising. I just think that you want to be in it, you've got to live it. We'll see. Craven's the same. Just cut a lot of weight. There's the right hand over the top.
Nice. That was
not got the energy, Shaw. And that was a huge round for Craven. He's going to go on to retain his British number one if he keeps doing what he's doing. Here's some of the action. It was a one-sided round that really for performance so far, Gavin, against a
Final
very dangerous
10 seconds.
Operator indeed.
So, ladies and gentlemen, please get behind both fighters as they come out for the fifth and final round.
Seconds. Going to round seven. Number five then.
Round
Craven
five.
Handily ahead. Shaw needs a knockout. Try for it.
Craven's just got to give him this first 30 seconds of this round, just move, let him settle.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, not get involved in a big crazy slugfest. It's not smart. Good balance.
Good balance shown from Craven there. Shaw's still got rockets though, hasn't he, Gab? You can still feel it.
Yeah, he's still dangerous. He's the type of fighter that's dangerous every second of every round, right till the last bell. That's why you've got to give him respect. You can't switch off at him.
Although brave man and a strong competitor, but this young, hungry little man, 72.5 kilo. Another Christian, I would say, Shaw Craven has got to, nutritionally wise, stay on point. He took Shaw seriously. Looked at the clock, Shaw. Time ticks away.
Yeah. think this is what happens. I think Joe, you see Joe Craven now, this is the result of him taking...
Look, he needed a better performance against what he did against Jake Purdy, because that wasn't, was it?
Well, what he's done is he's had a fight camp this time, not a weight loss camp.
But he's got to live it in between,
Gavin. Exactly.
You know that better than anybody.
I've seen people do it before, ballooning up in weight, and it affects your performance. You cannot do it. You've got to live it. 24 hours a day, you've got to live it.
But Shaw is going to go out on his shield with his head held high. But he was just kicked to the post, really, by a younger and a fresher young fighter.
Good performance.
Yeah, great performance from Craven. Fair play to him. He did well there. And he took him serious, and he had to take Shaw seriously. He wouldn't.
You see the
viciousness in his stuff.
You know, the funny thing is, though, every time I watch Joe Craven, I always get the feeling, it is edge-of-the-seat stuff, because I always get the feeling he does leave you with that little bit of risk every single time.
He's an enjoyable fighter.
He's enjoyable to watch.
Indeed, he's an enjoyable fighter to watch, but like I said, you know, you've got to live it outside the ring. But he can't criticise a kid. He's just beat very strong fighter in Chris Shaw.
Great performance.
And a great performance. Fair play to him. Does our MC Douglas McCadden gives us a decision.
To the centre of the ring,
very, very warm, and congratulations to Joe Craven and commiserations to Chris Shaw. Always value for money and an excellent fighter and person.
And first of all, ladies and gentlemen, please, again, another massive round of applause for both fighters. And after the full five rounds, we now go to the judges' scorecards. And the judges have reached a unanimous decision in favour of your winner. And still, UK number one in the red corner, Joe Craven. And your appreciation, please, for Chris Shaw.